Okay, what's up guys? I'm finally escaping Chongqing. It was a real mission to get out of there though. I thought I just had to get a metro train to the Chongqing North Station, but then I got there and I couldn't see my gate anywhere. Talked to someone who spoke English and turns out there's actually two squares that are really far apart, and that they didn't say that on my ticket, and I was actually really far from where I was meant to be with only less than an hour left for my train. So I got back on the metro, went to where I thought I could get to the other square. It was completely in the wrong direction. Came back to my original station. At that point I only had less than 30 minutes to get to my station. So I thought I'd sprint out of there and try and find a taxi. Then I saw the bus that the ticket lady actually told me I should get. So I ran to there just as I was getting there and sped off. And it was really looking like I was gonna miss my train. But then this Chinese lady selling water started talking to me in Chinese, so I showed her my ticket. I was like, I'm gonna miss my train, even though we couldn't speak each other's languages. And then she just waved over this dude on a motorbike. And I jump on the back of the motorbike with like my big suitcase and my backpack. And like just try and grab onto this guy, and he speeds off down the motorway. I've got no helmet on or anything. And then yeah, he gets me to the right station in like less than 5 minutes. So that guy was a real lifesaver. But yeah, even if you try to escape Chongqing, it still sucks you back in. But luckily I've escaped and I'm on my way to Chengdu now. So hopefully it'll, you know, be less terrifying than Chongqing. Okay guys, and I've just arrived here in Chengdu, escaped Chongqing, thank God. This city's got about 11 million people who live here, and they're famous for having giant pandas and spicy food, but we'll see what else we get up to. Alright, cool, I got my metro ticket with a little panda on it. The other thing Chengdu is famous for, of course, is being the capital of Sichuan province, so that means they have the Sichuan sauce, the infamous Sichuan sauce.
Wait, you guys know Sichuan sauce? I want Sichuan sauce! Where's my Sichuan sauce? I'm Kendall Rick! Wubba lubba dub dub! I'm Kendall Rick!
Rick! Rick! Rick!
I'm Kendall Rick!
Rick! Rick!
And now I've just got to find my hostel, but I'm already feeling better about this city. It seems less confusing and smells better. Just seems a lot better than Chongqing. Alright, what's up guys? I had a suggestion from my buddy Davis to try and find some spicy food and then try it on camera. So I found some Chengdu hot pot. Yeah, let's see how spicy this is. As you can see, the broth is like bright red and there's chilies everywhere. So this looks really spicy. The thing with it is though, it's not spicy all at once. You eat this over a long time. So we'll see how long I can eat this before I start to not be able to eat anymore. All right guys, I've been eating the hot pot for about a good 5 or 10 minutes now. I think they maybe went easy on me because I'm white. It's not too spicy, but it's really delicious. So maybe I'll have to find something else that actually will be funny for you guys to watch. But yeah, highly recommend getting hot pot. It's really fucking good. Alright guys, I finished eating my hot pot. I got too full to eat anymore. But in terms of spiciness, you know, it didn't kill me. Sure, I had some watermelon, but it wasn't like too extreme. So hopefully maybe tomorrow I can find something that'll actually be funny to watch on camera. I'd give that maybe in spiciness scale maybe like a 6.5 out of 10. It was also a really good price. As you see, I got all that food and I'm pretty sure it's like a buffet. You can eat as much as you like.
and it was like 50 RMB, which is about $10, and I got a beer, watermelon, so yeah, very cheap. I'm just gonna go back and chill at the hostel now, but yeah, tomorrow we'll see what I do.
The next day.
Good morning, guys, and welcome to a beautiful Chengdu Sunday morning. I'm out here in the center of Chengdu. If you look around me, got like a mall down here in this really giant square. And if you look up that way, it's Chairman Mao. I'll say while I'm in China, he's a cool guy. But yeah, we'll see what there is to do around here. Bit of another funny story though. I was in my hostel last night. I was meant to go and see the pandas today, and I was gonna get up early, and my alarm went off, and then I just hear this dude in the room, and he's like throwing up everywhere in the bathroom. So I'm like, I don't want to use the bathroom now. So I just kind of stayed in bed, waited for him to leave. He kept throwing up like multiple times, and it sounded like really watery. And then at one point, some other person who was in the room was using the bathroom, and he went, the vomit guy went to go use it again. The door was locked. And then you just hear him like sprint out the door, slam the door. And then when I eventually got up at about 11:30, there was like vomit stains all in the hallway. So it's not perfect, but you know, so far better than Chongqing. Yeah, and there he is, the man, the myth, the legend, Chairman Mao. If you don't know anything about Chairman Mao, he was the guy who led the resistance against the Japanese in World War II, and then eventually he founded modern China. He was the leader for like 25, 30 years, and he was pretty much the guy who got everything up and running in China. But sort of at a high cost, we'll say. But you know, good on him for starting this awesome modern country. What's up, guys? I'm just out here in this nice little park. Got some like traditional Chinese buildings, and there's like a pond and stuff. Just enjoying my favorite Chinese drink, watermelon Fanta. It's only 3 yuan for this bottle, so that's like 60 cents, I think. But yeah, quite a nice, relaxing little park they have here. What you see in front of me here, guys, in China, it's kind of frowned upon to not be married by the time you hit 25. So all these posters going down here are actually advertisements for people who want to get married. And you can see, like, I think this person's born in 1990, this person's born 1982, 1979, but yeah, there's girls and boys here, just all looking to get married. Yo, what's up? Good morning, guys. Welcome to the last day in Chengdu. I'm out here in the Panda...
What? It's a step.
I'm out here in the Panda Research Breeding Ground, just checking out some pandas. If you see over in this jungle, there's some pandas. And I'll bring up some cute footage I just saw of them now.
This panda's twerking.
Twerk, girl, I wanna see you twerk. I throw a little money if you twerk. I don't really think you can twerk. Twerk, if you broke, go to work. Make that big booty twerk. Make that big booty twerk.
Now this research base is home to almost 100 pandas, black and white ones and red ones. So pretty much most of the pandas in the world are made in the space. And it's actually mating season, so hopefully we might be able to spot some baby pandas. We'll see.
This guy's going ham on the bamboo.
I got broads in Atlanta, just to throw in the family. Credit cards in the scammers, hitting the licks in the family. Legacies, family, waiting to see, look like a panda. Going out like a Montana, honey killers on the helmets. Legacies, family, waiting to see, family. Pockets full, Danny, selling ball, candy. Man on the macho like Randy, the chopper go out to for granted. This nigga bullet your bandit, hope you killers understand.
Alright, this is pretty hilarious. It says Floyd Mayweather, the boxer, named a panda. TMT, Floyd Mayweather.
what a douche.
Named a panda after himself. Alright guys, while everyone's watching the big pandas over there eat their bamboo, there's some secret baby pandas here. The other place that had baby pandas was absolutely packed, but I don't think the people know that these ones are here. So these guys are just chilling out. Oh, they've realized now.
Legacy, Phantom, Wayacy, Panda, Pegasus, Danny, Selling Ball, Candy, may not the macho like Randy, the chopper go out to for granted, then nigga pull up your banner, hope you killers understand me. Panda, Panda.
Alright guys, I'm all done here at the Panda Research Base. Really enjoyed it. The pandas were really beautiful and amazing to see. So that was awesome. But I've got one more thing to show you in Chengdu. So we'll skip to that now. So if you remember from the start of the video, my friend Davis challenged me to eat the spiciest thing in Chengdu. I haven't really found anything that's apparently spicier than hot pot, but I did find this. You see that? That's a Snickers, but that is a little chili pepper on there. So it must mean that it is chili flavored Snickers. So let's give this a go. All right, well, it smells like a regular Snickers. Let's give it the taste test. It's not very spicy at all, but the chili just makes it taste nice. So, sorry I couldn't shriek in pain for you guys, but, you know, maybe in another city. Anyway, thanks for watching this one, and please subscribe if you're liking them. And, yeah, smash that like button and drop a comment below. Thank you. Yes, I.